Welcome friends to another edition of the Silk Route to Excel at Work. Hope in the past few videos you have learned something new or refreshed what you already know. In this session we'll have a look at the conditional formatting options in Excel. This is a very basic sales report on a particular product for each day of the week. Monday to Sunday, and these are the products sold. It can be in numbers or in rupees or in hundreds of rupees, thousands of rupees, whatever you feel like. So what I want to know is, how are my sales for a week at a glance? Let us assume my median is 40, and then all days of sales above 40, I need to highlight them. For this, the easiest way to go through is by using conditional formatting. This version of Excel, Office 365, is right on the home page. This is the conditional formatting. I select the data which I want to conditionally format. Formatting can mean changing the color, the background color, the font color, it's bold, italics, underline, almost practically anything which you can see on the screen. So here, go to conditional formatting. You get all sorts of things here. Highlight sales rules, top bottom rules, data bars, color scales, icon sets. We'll see all of them one by one depending on the time of the session. We start with the basics. We want to highlight cells which are greater than. Our set is, let us say, 40. You want to fill it with light red fill with darkness is default here. You can change it to yellow fill with dark yellow, green fill with dark green. Let us make it green. So this is how it looks. So all cells above 40, write it this way. If you want to check it out, let us make 39, let us make it 41. This turns to green. 45, is it 35? Goes back to its original default color of black color on a white background. Want to go further? Check this out. All green means it's above your benchmark or whatever value is set. You want to know when which is less than. So again, less than 40. Light fill with red dot test. Yeah, this will do. So this is it. When a value changes 40, means it is just at your break even. Let us assume 40 is a break even, it's at 40. Anything below 40 is in red, anything above 40 is in green. We'll again go through here. Between equal to text that contains date occurring duplicate values, we'll come to this later. You can also see the top 10 items. When you go for another rule, if it is part of the same rule, it's not a problem. If not, when you click, let us say, the top 10 items or top 10 percentage, because there are just 7 items here, we will go with the top 10%. I need to know the top 10%, or let us say top 15% or 20%. You can just change the values here. We fill that with another color, let us say yellow fill with dark yellow text. Yeah, so this. So what happened to the earlier rule? Yes, to see that, manage rules, there are three rules here. Top 20%, cell value less than 40, cell value greater than 40. So this sequence of rules which is applied here. This is the first, this is the second, and this is the third. So with this comes, obviously, these two don't work on the cell. So here, if you want to remove only 20%, you can remove these both. You delete these cells, you can, whichever is highlighted, you can delete it here. Delete this rule, delete this rule, apply it, you will see that no longer applies here. You want to know only the top 40, don't, you're not bothered basically about what is less than 40, delete this rule, apply it. This shows only those cells which are having above 40. Like I said earlier, if you want to go for top bottom rules, top, let us make it now 30%, you can type it here, 30%. You want different format, yellow fill with dark yellow. Like I said, there are many formats here. You can do red text, you can red border, you can custom format it to whatever you want here. Basically, the conditional formatting is a very powerful tool to analyze your data, display it the way you or your colleagues or your boss can understand it better at a glance. So, I urge you to go through all this and share any issues that you may face and ideas that you have implemented after looking at this. Share it with all of us so all of us can excel at work. Thanks for watching.